Three summers ago I was staying in a caravan a long way from the nearest city. It was usually pitch black at night. I had given my word that I would not smoke inside, so at 1 a.m. I stepped outside for a cigarette. After a few minutes of standing in the darkness, I realized that I could see my hand quite clearly, something I'd noticed that I could not do on previous nights. So I looked up, expecting to see the glow of the full moon. But the moon was nowhere in sight. Instead, there was a long glowing cloud directly overhead. The Romans called it the Via Galactica, the Road of Milk. Today we call it the Milky Way. For those who missed the lesson at school that day, the basic facts are these. Remembering that one light year is equivalent to 6 trillion miles, our galaxy has a total diameter of somewhere around 100,000 light years. Our Sun is located towards the edge of one of the galaxy's spiral arms, about 26,000 light years out from the central bulge of the galaxy. It takes 200 to 250 million years for the Sun to complete one orbit of the central bulge. Surrounding the galaxy, above and below the disk, in a spherical halo, there are approximately 200 globular clusters, which may contain up to 1 million stars each. The Milky Way itself contains 200 billion stars, give or take. These numbers are essential to understanding what a galaxy is, but when contemplating them, some part of the human mind protests that it cannot be so. Yet an examination of the evidence brings you to the conclusion that it is. And if you take that conclusion out on a clear, dark night and look up, you might see something that will change your life. This is what a galaxy looks like from the inside, from the suburbs of our Sun. Through binoculars, for every star you can see with your naked eye, you can see 100 around it, all suspended in a grey-blue mist. But through a modest telescope, if you wait for your eyes to adjust to the dark and get the focus just right, you will see that mist for what it really is. More stars, like dust, fading into what tastes like infinity. But you've got to have the knowledge. Seeing is only half of it. That night 3 years ago, I knew a small part of what's out there. The kinds of things, the scale of things, the age of things, the violence and destruction, appalling energy, hopeless gravity, and the despair of distance. But I feel safe, because I know my world is protected by the very distance that others fear. It's like the universe screams in your face, "Do you know what I am? How grand I am? How old I am? Can you even comprehend what I am? What are you compared to me?" And when you know enough science, you can just smile up at the universe and reply, "Dude, I am you." When I looked at the galaxy that night, I knew the faintest twinkle of starlight was a real connection between my comprehending eye along a narrow beam of light to the surface of another sun. The photons my eyes detect, the light I see, the energy with which my nerves interact, came from that star. I thought I could never touch it, yet something from it crosses the void and touches me. I might never have known. My eyes saw only a tiny point of light, but my mind saw so much more. I see the invisible bursts of gamma radiation from giant stars converted into pure energy by their own mass, the flashes that flashed from the far side of the universe long before Earth had even formed. I can see the invisible microwave glow of the background radiation left over from the Big Bang. I see stars drifting aimlessly at hundreds of kilometers per second, and the space-time curving around them. I can even see millions of years into the future. That blue twinkle will blow up one day, sterilizing any nearby solar systems in an apocalypse that makes the wrath of human gods seem pitiful by comparison. Yet it was from such destruction that I was formed. Stars must die so that I can live. I stepped out of a supernova. And so did you.